I was born in El Paso, Texas, while my parents were there under special orders of Congress, Operation Paperclip. They were living in William Beaumont Annex housing at Fort Bliss with the Wernher von Braun team. About half of the team were taken by bus daily out to White Sands Proving Grounds so that they could share with captains of industry and professors and various ones that were interested in what is this unique thing, this rocket that they built back in Germany during the war.
To the V-2. It was so fast and very destructive. I was born in 1936, so I remember the war pretty well. Grew up through the Blitz in Portsmouth. Had my first experience with injury when a V-1 came down on my street. It killed all the neighbors and my uncle. It was kind of strange. I'm on the receiving end of the vengeance weapons of Germany. And 20 years later, I'm sitting with Wernher von Braun in the blockhouse. Von Braun was primarily the V-2. If the Germans had had it a year or more earlier, it could have made an effect on the results of the war.
I myself and everybody you see here have decided to go west, and I think our decision was not one of expediency, but a moral decision. We knew that we had created a new means of warfare, and the question as to what victorious nation we were willing to entrust this brainchild of ours was a moral decision more than anything else.
I don't feel they were really happy working on what they thought was a weapon, but they saw it that it was the Americans against the Russians in the Cold War that was starting to brew. And in that way, I feel they thought that they could now maybe make amends for what had occurred before.
The V-2 was streets ahead of its time. That rocket was the foundation for the Redstone rocket. The Redstone stepped into the Jupiter. We then took a Jupiter tank and 8 Redstone rockets and built a Saturn I. Then we took that whole concept and built the Saturn V. And von Braun had his hand in that from day one.